So if I am joyful, why can't I exist forever? Why death is compassion? Death is compassion. When you do not know the process of life, you fear death. But once, if you have… see, you were in school, the experience of school was wonderful, but don't you want to go to college? Death is just like that. Your experience of life has been wonderful, but you want to go beyond and see what the hell it's about. Isn't it? Now, the ignorant in the world have always been seeking immortality. People who did not experience anything beyond their physical body, those fools have always been seeking immortality. Especially when societies become affluent, somebody becomes a king or an emperor, he's always thinking of immortality, because he lives in the fear of death always. One such fool on the planet was Alexander the Great. He was an extremely miserable man. Do you know his life, personal life? He went into bouts of violence or bouts of indulging in physical pleasures and drinking. He used to get so drunk. Once a very exquisite palace that was there in Constantinople, he and his friends just set fire to it because they were drunk. So he was just wallowing between these two because there is so much misery. Just to avoid that, you have to do something. Intense activity is violence. It gives you some break. Drinking gives you some break. When you are miserable, this is how people are doing their life. Working like crazy, not because they are joyful, not because their work is of any meaning to life around them, simply because they have to do something, otherwise they'll go mad. If they have free time on their hands, they will go crazy. They have to work crazy or they have to get drunk and somehow tranquilize themselves and sleep. This Alexander is doing in an extreme way, but he wants to live forever. Though the experience of life is so bitter, he wants to live forever. He was searching immortality and he heard Indian yogis are capable of immortality. So that's why he was moving towards India. So somewhere in the Hindu Kush, they caught hold of a yogi and he came to him and said, "I want the secret of immortality. I've heard Indian yogis are capable of immortality. They live forever and ever." The yogi looked at the man and he knows what an utter fool he is. At the same time, he knows he has a powerful sword. You have to handle it properly, you know. So he told him, he said, "See, go this way. In this particular forest, at this particular place," he described the geography of the place, "there is this little cave. Inside the cave, there's a little pond. You drink the water from this pond and you will be immortal." Alexander pursued. With the bravest of his men, he just went searching and then he found that cave that the yogi had described. Then he chased away all his men. He doesn't want them to drink it and become immortal, you know. He wants to drink it himself. So he walked into the cave and there was a pool as the yogi had described. He was just about to drink. When he was just about to put his hands into the water and drink, there was a crow which was sitting at the edge of the pool and the crow said, "Wait, just wait. Before you drink this water of immortality, just listen to my story. Long time ago, I don't remember how long ago, I drank from this pool and here I am. I cannot even commit suicide because I'm immortal." I just can't die. I have seen everything that I have to see with life, but I am just sitting here. I don't know what to do. I cannot die. No matter what I do, I cannot die. You know what a curse it is. The most horrible thing that can happen to you is, you cannot die. Isn't it so? So let life follow its course. When you're alive, you assist aliveness because death doesn't need your support. Death is super efficient. When it happens well, isn't it? Did you ever see, you know, half death, did not perform death properly? No. Death always happens, absolutely, totally. It's super efficient. It does not need anybody's assistance. But life is not like that. You can live half a life and go, isn't it? Life needs your assistance and involvement. So, you don't try to do death, you try to do life because life needs constant assistance from you. Otherwise, all of us are alive, but all of us don't live life to the same extent, isn't it? Because it needs constant assistance, otherwise life won't happen. But death doesn't need your assistance. But when it happens, it's a huge compassion because that's the biggest relief. If you really have a hard day of working, the biggest relief is just to fall on your bed and be dead for the night. Isn't it so? Sleep is death, isn't it so? Yes, sleep is death. It's just that you wake up in the morning. This is also like that. You do wake up somewhere else, but let's not bother about those things. But definitely, when you fall on the bed and fall asleep, isn't that the biggest relief? Sleep means temporarily you don't exist. Your non-existence, is it a beautiful state? Yes? And I'm telling you, if you don't exist, this world would be so beautiful. Isn't it so? If human beings did not exist, this world is just fantastic, isn't it? Absolutely no problem. So, you must understand the blissfulness of being uncreated. Creation has its sweetness, but being uncreated is very, very blissful. If you're aware, if you're unaware, everything is a problem. Creation is a problem, beyond creation is a problem. Anyway, you're a believer in God. If you believe in God, always death is described as daivadin. What do you call it here? Upar, whatever. Yes? So, you're supposed to go and fall in the lap of God. That must be compassion, isn't it? Yes? Don't be too eager. Anyway, you'll get there. Right now, life needs assistance, so we're talking inner engineering. Death doesn't need your assistance. It'll happen, don't you worry about it.
For more on Sadhguru, visit www.ishafoundation.org.